To get a thorough understanding of all of audit's features, let's start by using a blank Inforiver visual. I'm going to come over to my fields pane and populate it. I'm going to put my brand subsidiaries hierarchy on my rows, and then I'm going to add my sales, my prior year sales, my plan, and my forecast. And even these basic changes of adding the fields to the wells can be observed if we come over to advanced and go over to our audits log, where you can see that the measures that were added to the wells are captured in here. Now, for the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to go ahead and fast forward to a completed report where we've added a ton of other things that can be captured in the audit log as well. Now we can see a build with a few more changes made to it. Let's start by navigating the audit log a little bit and exploring some of the interactive features. We can see that the top item up here was that a measure label was changed to forecast. We'll actually hover over this and select it. It will apply a filter up here at the top and also indicate that this forecast column here has two items in the audit log, one where the name was changed and another one where it was added. Additionally, as you hover over each of these, notice that you can individually delete any of the audit log options, or you can also reset all of them. I'll also mention that you can export these if desired to do further analysis in external tools. Now, one other really great feature is with any of these, you have an option to click the comment, which allows you to add comments to review at a later date. Let's go ahead and clear back out of this filter again. You can also observe other changes, such as forecast measure was removed here. Again, anytime you see one of these hover options, that means that if you click it, it will both apply a filter in the audit log and also highlight the area in the table that that change was made. In this case, there is a cell edit to change the value to 4 million. Additionally, you can use the table as a filter for the audit log as well. Let's come over here and select one of the rows. Coming back to the audit log, you can see that there are two changes recorded. The first one down here was that a row reordering happened where the original position was 7 and it was moved to the current position of 5. Additionally, up here at the top, there was a row group added for all of these called no subsidiaries. Clear out of this again. There's also a wildcard search option to be able to search within the audit log for any specific values. And there's some advanced search options if you come up to here. You have multiple options to be able to search by type, just audit items related to data editing or audit items related to formatting, with the addition to also filter by date range as well. Plus a really nice way to filter to just logs that have comments.